So you might recognize TVP from these two videos. And I am sorry to break it to you, but it was all a fake and more like a scam. Because as it turned out, Tsubajashi's research that I covered in those videos actually never existed, and that the entire TVP project was based on a massive lie. If you're not familiar with him, basically he's a developer from Germany who claimed to have built a new revolutionary architecture for video frame interpolation, specifically made for anime. Over the last 2 years, he has spent his time creating a cult-like community in order to spread the growth of TVP. It even got as far as some people in his community treating him like some god. In reality though, he scammed his developer into doing all the work for him and spent most of the time doing nothing, constantly making absolutely outrageous claims like these to basically boost his ego or fool potential investors. Yep, it's that ridiculous. He stole all of his models from a 14-year-old and claimed them as his own, never giving credit. Not only that, everything he ever did was stolen in some way. We'll go over all of this in a greater detail in the rest of this video, so sit back and relax and ready to enjoy the biggest tea in the AI upscaling community.
Okay, I know this looks like Kane.
Totally not.
We have a lot to cover here, so let's not waste any more time and let me answer the most important question. How could all this happen, and why did no one notice? To answer this, we have to go back in time to fully see the whole picture. We start off on NMKD's server, another developer who's mostly known for developing flow frames and recently Stable Diffusion GUI, and Tsubajashi was a moderator on his server. His position as a moderator in the NMKD server increased people's trust in him. His activity on the server also most likely contributed to the trust people gave him, as he appeared to be a fairly helpful and knowledgeable person. Spoiler, he isn't. Conveniently, he uploaded his CV to his GitHub, from where we can deduce that he was working as an IT assistant at that time for an insurance company, which is basically the same as tech support. He had no prior reputation other than his MPV configuration, which by the way has an insane amount of problems he couldn't fix and always blamed the problems onto the user's system, rather than himself or various other potential causes, and defaulted to his trademark excuse of, "I'm already in talks with the maintainers," which is the farce he still uses to this day to make it appear as he is actually working on things and to dupe his paying Patreons. So how could someone clearly as inexperienced as him come up with such a seemingly revolutionary technology? Tsubajashi had been experimenting with interpolation since the late 2020, where he uploaded this particular video in November. This appears to be the beginning of what would become TVP. While seeking through the video, you may encounter a few artifacts such as this one. As you can see here, it blurs rather than warps. Kane, coincidentally, has the same exact characteristic. Whenever people brought this comparison up, he would come up with random excuses and later outright banning people from his Discord server when even mentioning Kane. This is where Hubert, the developer of Kane app, comes into play. He was active on NMKD's Discord as well, and Tsubajashi befriended him as he was interested in the models Hubert was training. Hubert eventually taught Tsubajashi the basics of training a model, sending him a few models he worked on in the process, but Tsubajashi completely disregarded this. Seeing all the money and reputation NMKD has been getting through his own GUI, Tsubajashi probably became jealous and envious and went on straight up stealing Hubert's Kane app UI, only changing the layout and bundled the models he got in the DM from Hubert. Initially, his newly stolen UI had credit to Hubert, but it was later removed with the first public alpha release to his Patreon. As to why Hubert didn't try to speak about it, Tsubajashi threatened legal actions against him. As a young teen, it's frightening to receive such a threat. Hence, Hubert stayed silent. Luckily, Hubert's not on his own anymore and Tsubuyashi's lawyers do not exist. So we can easily prove this once and for all with absolute proof that Tsubuyashi is nothing more than a scammer and a scum. One of the first evidence is Tsuba in his absolute wisdom left the license file from Hubert's model inside the model that he used for his Discord bot. If we open it up, we can clearly see that this model in fact belongs to Hubert and not Tsubuyashi. Still not convinced? Let's go onto his Discord and compare the artifacts from the footage of his bot with Hubert's model CVP-V6. It's exactly the same. By the way, as for the default TVP model, it is exactly the same as the RVP-V1K model made by Sudo. This can be proven by examining the file's MD5 hash. Well, this hasn't aged well, did it? Now we finally got the major evidence out of the way, let's get back to our initial timeline. He would go on to advertise CVP to people that had issues with flow frames or were dissatisfied with the results it would provide, either through DM or blatantly on NMKD's Discord, usually discrediting NMKD's work behind his back and telling people how incompetent he is and how he only steals from others. How ironic, right? Anyways, through a friend of mine, Bubblemint, I became aware of TVP and they convinced me to make a video about it, which would turn out to be a pretty large mistake on Bubblemint and I. After I finished making the video, he was already making ridiculous claims like collaborating with animation studios and amassing terabytes of anime frames donated by the studios or licensed by him. None of this, of course, was true when many of us asked to see the frames or the emails he had with the studios. He even claimed that he was fluent in Japanese, which I don't even know how to feel about that. Back before I made a TVP video, Tsubuyashi explained to me how TVP worked by essentially just explaining Kane and fooled me with further lies, and promised me that he was gonna write a paper about TVP. The video about TVP generated a lot of attention to him and his own Discord server, and his Discord server saw rapid growth after my video was released. But by the time that you're watching this, those videos would have already been removed. After the video had been released, Tsubuyashi followed with some minor updates which involved some more stealing. Then after a few updates, we eventually saw sneak peeks of what would be dubbed Beta 8. This would be a full suite of AI tools which would include upscaling and interpolation. However, the upscaling was also stolen. His upscaler was just real ESR again with the anime model V3. Nothing special. Yet, he claimed that it was his and it was revolutionary. And now we're getting to another key figure who unfortunately became aware of TVP through my video called Mafiosnik, aka Mafio. After seeing my video, Mafio offered to assist Tsubuyashi to add something AI related to his portfolio. Mafio, on the other hand, had no idea what he was getting himself into. Tsubuyashi immediately promised Mafio money and a job, none of which he ever received. However, he still continued as it would look good on his portfolio, as at that time he knew nothing about the absolute disaster that TVP was. As time passed, development of Beta 8 progressed thanks to Mafio, meanwhile Tsubuyashi did nothing to help. Concerning the things Tsubuyashi had promised Mafio, he had told a few people that he would be forming a company for TVP in the hopes of attracting investments and fundings. Three people in particular even offered 50k each to invest in this company. Tsubuyashi in reality was unconcerned. Mafio had tried to persuade him to go to the town hall and fill out the necessary paperwork to start a business, even offering to pay the registration fee multiple times, which he still never did out of laziness. And also within that period of time, Tsubuyashi got fired from his job and lied to his community that he quit it to work full-time on TVP. Of course, Mafio noticed Tsubuyashi's lack of concern for TVP and began to question TVP's legitimacy and whether or not he would be paid. And as Tsubuyashi pushed more work onto Mafio, he became more familiar with the code and began to notice where Tsubuyashi had stolen the code from. So while Mafio did all of this work for Tsubuyashi without getting paid a single dime, he even provided him money for food when he lost his job, essentially going into the red with his work on TVP. Tsubuyashi didn't even offer a small portion of the capital that possible investors were willing to pay him. While Mafio was working his ass off, basically doing 95% of the work, Tsubuyashi once again did barely anything. He played games, squandered time configuring Linux distributions that no one cared about, and claimed that he was hard at work on Beta 8 while also claiming false release dates. truly a disgusting behavior. At heart, Tsuburayashi is a pathological and compulsive liar, claiming that he has a job at Valve, previously worked for Topaz Labs, contributing to Proton, SVP, and RPCS3, being offered a job at Tencent to work on NCNN, getting NVIDIA A6000 cards from random people at conventions, having multiple famous people on speed dial, including the author of One Piece, pretending to be insane at piano, and just so much more, while his online CV claims otherwise. It's honestly impossible to cover all of his lies in a single video. Not even Bubblemint was able to cover all of his lies in a 30-page document. However, no one knew about this, hence the hype for a new release never died. Most people probably remember that portable Python was one of the reasons as to why Beta 8 was being delayed. Tsuburayashi claimed that he was having packaging problems which was causing Beta 8 to be delayed and that he was in contact with the package maintainers, which is his trademark excuse. In reality, all of this was false. He was just simply too lazy to package anything. Days, weeks, and even months passed, but there was no sign of Tsuburayashi doing any of the work. Mafia would remind Tsuburayashi every day and inquire about the packaging process, and Tsuburayashi would, as usual, respond with his trademark reply. He even took it as far as to ghost Mafia and many others to pretend to be in meetings with famous animation companies, and then would reply to them after he had finished faking. This is when Mafia decided to take the matters into his own hands and package it himself. It took him 2 hours to finish. Tsuburayashi knew he was lying to both Mafia and everyone in his community. This is why he backtracked on his promise of making TVP open source with me and many others, for obvious reasons. Tsuburayashi then went on to discredit Mafia's work in public, made false claims about it not being packaged correctly, and him wanting to package in a way that would work on all operating systems, which is impossible by the way. Furthermore, he proceeded to attack Bubblemint, who first claimed that Mafia had managed to package portable Python correctly. This further proves his effort to silence people who would speak against him. It's honestly depressing how Tsuburayashi used such means to protect his brainwashing empire. After this event, people who were aware of the truth of TVP decided to lay low for a while. However, both Hubert and Bubblemint eventually got bored and indirectly provocated Tsuburayashi in his Discord server by reacting with a broom emote. And this is a reference to Tsuburayashi allegedly beating his cats with a broom while on a call with Mafio. To this day, he probably has not figured out the true meaning behind it. Of course, at this point, Mafio got fed up because he had done pretty much all the work while simultaneously being called a liar by Tsuburayashi's community. He decided to go to Tsuburayashi and work on his own project called Enchancr. This is essentially the promised Beta 8 with TVP entirely removed. It contains the best interpolation and upscaling AI with a beautiful GUI powered by both TensorRT and NCNN, meaning that people with old GPUs may enjoy it. The source code releases together with this video, with builds available on his Patreon right now. Feel free to go support him on his Patreon so he can continue working on this. And during the time that Mafia ghosted Tsuburayashi, Tsuburayashi kept claiming that development was going very well and said that he was quickly learning how to code in JS and that he was working on a DRM for TVP, and convincing people to keep waiting for Beta 8 because he was supposedly working so hard on it. Now, I'm no expert, but pretending to work on something you haven't touched in months and pretending development is going well while your developer has seemingly vanished sounds like he's trying to scam people for a passive income. This leads to now the present day. Tsuburayashi continuously lied to his community and everyone surrounding it. All of what he says was false, and he may have seemed like a friendly and a nice person, but in reality, I'd say he's the complete opposite of that. He has lied to both his family and supporters for his own monetary gain. His words and statements may have seemed true, but if you dig deeper, you'll start to notice inconsistencies with what he says. Even the support he offers seems to always lead to a typical Windows versus Linux argument, which I wouldn't really call support, but rather forcing your opinion onto someone else. I would suggest going back and read any chats you had with Tsuburayashi if you ever had any. Everything he has said should make a lot more sense now that everything has been revealed. To the Patreons who are subscribed to Tsuburayashi's Patreon, if I were you, I would cancel my subscriptions immediately. He really does not deserve to take any more money and should probably go out there and get a real job, rather than claiming that the money he receives from the government for being unemployed is his job. After this video is released exposing exposing him, he might come up with an even crazier excuse or conspiracy theory about how we're trying to take his work and make money off it, or something like that. But obviously, you should know who to trust. A group of people that have been preparing evidence against a person that clearly does scummy things, or a guy DMing you and forcing his opinion onto you. This is the first time someone has done something like this in the online AI community, hence I wanted to release this video on my main channel so that I can spread the awareness of how easily someone can pull off something like this anywhere, simply by proposing fake AI technology, verbally making promises such as writing a paper, faking results, and plagiarizing work. The lessons here, especially for myself, is to always look for credible sources and reproducible results. While I would make the excuse for myself that I always wanted to share the coolest and the latest technology and some just don't have the actual papers yet, this is definitely not being responsible when I have an audience I have given trust in my words. It is ironic how I always test the AIs but couldn't identify the technology was all stolen. Pretty funny, right? So yeah, Enchancr was also made by a group of people with a key individual as Mafio and Hubert and Sudo for supporting him for his work, which then provides people way out of TVP and convert into a much better GUI with a lot of new engines, much faster speed for some models, improvements, and things that TVP does not have and will probably never have. I really hope everyone will still give me a chance and continue to support my YouTube channel, and I promise that I will not have things like this happen again no matter how small it is. So yeah, sorry guys. I hope I can still see you guys in the next one.